this episode, everyone. In this one, we're going to be putting together the primary hulls. Before I actually put it together, I've just been going using my model, the new one, as a reference for painting. So I've been doing a little bit of paint work on there. I've got to do some touch-up yet, but I found my decal pad here from my other model, and it's got some extra decals on there, like this here. That goes to the rear part of the impulse deck here. So I'll be adding those decals on to the model as well. And there's these here for the back of the either side of the docking bay doors. Those will be going on there as well. Okay, got that all done there. Looks good. And I redid the phaser tips there. They were red and they were supposed to be copper. That's copper now. Did some detailing along here. And I did the underside of the saucer as well. Before I put these two halves together, I want to get the neck here done. But on this one here, the little nib that's stuck up there, that goes in here. Broke off, so I have to make a new one, and then I'm just going to use my heat gun to melt the plastic in place here, and then it'll be ready to go. Okay, I got this, and it fits beautifully in there. Just got to drill a hole on top there where the other one goes or went, and put it in. It's good there. Now, what I'm going to do with this, put it in there like that, maybe around there, and I'm going to melt the tip underneath here so it holds it in place and glue it as well. I got it glued in place. I'll just take the tip of this, melt it down. There we go. Looks good. I'm just about ready to put the two halves together. But I gotta do the torpedo launcher area here first. The next step here to the build is to finish off the neck. And that requires two LEDs for the torpedo launcher here. So I'm gonna install them onto the launcher part here and then put it in place here. With the LEDs, I need them pointing at the opening here. So, gotta make them grow right there. And then cut that off there like that. So now one LED will go on this side like this, and then the other LED would be on the other side like this, both facing the opening here. There you go. Okay, and I got it all glued in place there. Now I can glue it into the slot that's supposed to go into. As with all red LEDs, I have to have a resistor on it. So I'm going to put the resistor on the negative side and I'll run it directly to the negative. It would be over here on this line here where you see the black wire going. And then the positive, of course, there. And then after that, it's ready for the side here to be put together. Okay, now before I close these up, I'm going to put these lines in here, just placing them in so I don't have to try and run them down there later. It's for the navigational lighting. I got two lines, separate lines going in. They'll be going to the faster and slower flashing navigational lighting. Okay, let's put these two together. There we go, all done. So just got to wait till that dries, and then I will attach it to this section here of the bottom part of the primary hull. There we go, it's all done. Now to marry these two pieces together. What I'm going to do in this part here is I'm going to do a layer of Gorilla Glue across here. What I actually did is I just took my iron and I melted the plastics all together. The two halves are melted together. And the part that I was sticking up, I flattened it all the way down. So it's locked in. It is not coming off. Looks good. Just gotta paint that over so no light goes through and hook up the wiring and it's ready to go. I got the contour putty there on the join lines. Once that's painted over after I sand it, you won't even know it was there. Let's do a quick lighting test. Looks good. Very nice. Okay. Yeah, okay. Looks good. Okay, before I can put that on here, I have to finish up wiring everything up. I got the main wiring here going to here to light up the neck, which goes down to the engineering hull. The only things I got to worry about now are these lighting here. This is the 1000. Yeah, 1000. Okay, that one there is the microfarad 1000. This is the 470 microfarad, which is the faster of the two. So this lighting here goes on to this circuit here, and the bridge and the lighting in the secondary hull go on this in here. Got the impulse lighting done. I have a 15 ohm resistor on the red LEDs. And on the navigational lighting red, 100 ohm on the bottom part of the saucer and 100 ohm on the top part of the saucer, which is that side right there. Okay, on the top part here, I got the these two here ready to go. I just painted this one green now, letting me know that's the positive side. And I got these lines here done. Just painted that one green. Got to let this paint dry. Main power for the hookup lighting to go into the bottom of the primary hull. Reason I got these taped here is to keep any of these metal parts here from touching, which would cause a short. Now I have to do the same thing with all of these points all along here. Cover them up with the tape to keep anything from shorting out. And then once the paint's dry, I can connect the two halves together. And then that's it. Primary hull is finished. Okay, time to put these two halves together now. Alright, so, got the main power line here. I'm going here. This will stay up. See, I run the main power line down to this lighting outfit here. So now I got this set of lights here, which go up to the bridge, the dome light up here. And that's going to go on this circuit right here, and I'll tie it in here. There we go, got them both tied in. Let's just do a quick lighting test, make sure this is working. Oh yeah. It's working! These other lights here, they're going to get tied in here and here for this circuit. Let's do one more lighting test before closing it up. Good. Very good. Looks good. Very nice. All right. Good. There we have it, folks. All done. One more lighting test. Always do lighting tests. Okay. There we go. Looks good. Very nice. Very nice indeed. All right. That's it for this episode, everyone. In the next one, we're going to be working on the secondary hull, getting that all put together. And then the final step would be mirroring both sections of the ship together. So please like, subscribe, and comment. Don't forget to share. And if you have any questions or you want me to do some commission work for you, contact me at modelbuilder501@yahoo.ca. I'll see you guys again next time. Catch you later. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.